Hey, gang. Hopefully you're all seeing the stream okay. We're just about 5 minutes between the 7A state semifinal between the Griggsville Perry Eagles and Oglesby Holy Family, who was a winner over Pontiac St. Mary's in the second quarterfinal game of the day. For those of you that may have seen the Waverly game on Thursday, imagine Oglesby is kind of a Waverly 2.0, built very similar and probably just a couple of steps up in the level of talent. Number 21 and number 11 are being the two guys you're going to want to keep an eye on through this game, number 21 and 11 for Oglesby. They performed really well today. They were the two guys that we've had in the scouting report as being the two guys to keep an eye on. After that, we hung out and watched Washington St. Patrick handle Kewaunee Visitation in a not exceptionally exciting contest. Both teams really seemed to struggle offensively. Kewaunee really had trouble in the first half getting anything going. And then in the fourth game of the day, we watched Lincoln Carroll Catholic, a team that Griggsville Perry has actually played before in summer league competition, defeat Royal Prairie View Ogden rather handily. They have what probably appears to be the number one player individually in the tournament. Really nice tall guard that stands at about 5'11", 6 foot tall. A solid team. But here we are getting ready for semifinals. It's been a long day. Thank you guys for hanging out this morning. Thanks for everybody tuning in today. Had well about 200 people checking out things this morning, so hopefully many of you are watching tonight with us and having a good time, and we will be back here at East Peoria one way or the other on Thursday evening. If we lose, we will be here at 6 o'clock. If we win, we will be playing for the state championship at 7:30 on Thursday night. So hopefully you won't have to watch a live stream because you'll be able to get in the car and come up and join us on Thursday evening one way or the other. And if not, we'll find a way to get a live stream to you one way or the other. Another nice crowd here for the Eagles tonight. A few people that didn't make it up in the morning are here now. Saw some of the junior high volleyball girls. Know that the high school boys are playing hard, down to 7, I believe, at half is what someone just told me. But we are getting ready here at East Peoria Central Junior High School, which is a nice facility. Imagine it a little bit like a Beardstown High School gymnasium if you have ever been there. One side of bleachers on this side. We are standing up on a concourse area that has a secondary row of bleachers here on the other side of the gym. Built just a lot like Beardstown High School's gym, minus the exceptionally annoying video board that they have. But we're going to get ready to go here, guys. Just about 2 minutes until tip-off and introductions of starting lineups. Once again, number 21 is one of the big players you're going to want to keep an eye on for Holy Family. Getting a look at these kids right now. So glad you guys are all here hanging out with us online on the Facebook. Once again, we remind you that share it online, let everybody know we're watching. That way we'll get a few more Eagle fans here in the house. As we get ready, once again, this is the 7-1A state semifinal at East Peoria Central Junior High. Here on the Whack-A-Mole pregame show. Whack-A-Mole pest removal. You've got moles to get rid of, just whack-a-mole with a hammer in your yard and get rid of them on your own. Whack-A-Mole pest removal, bringing you today's pregame show. Oglesby Holy Family will be the visitors on the scoreboard today, dressed in black with red and white trim. Oglesby, up around the Kewaunee area, if you're familiar with the state of Illinois.
The starting lineups for tonight's semifinal game. First, for the visitors on the scoreboard, Oglesby Holy Family.
Seth Adams, number 11, one of the guys you'll want to keep an eye on. Brandon Monroe, number 14, is the second starter, the guard. Seth Ferrari is number 35, one of the coolest names you're going to hear in the tournament. Josh Sandler, I believe, is that last name, at number 21. And number 32 is going to be the last starter for Holy Family. And Oglesby Holy Family has a large crew of assistant coaches. If you've seen the Eagles, you know the starting lineup. Michael Myers, number 3, the shooting guard. Flint Perk, number 5 at the forward, had 4 fouls, had a tough game in the quarterfinal today. Logan Gerke, number 11. Wyatt Lipkeman, one of the 2 guards up front, one of the Lipkeman twins. Lane Lipkeman, the other guard, number 32 for the Eagles. Garrett White, the head coach. Matt Hansen, his assistant. Big crowd here. Hope you guys are able to tune in and see everything okay. We're going to get ready to tip off here. Once again, if you've seen Waverly play, if you saw the sectional game, think of Holy Family a lot like Waverly. Maybe just to step up in a couple of the individual positions. Number 21, number 11, the 2 main guys you're going to want to keep an eye on this Holy Family team. This team shot well and very well to beat Pontiac St. Mary's. Wyatt Lipkin is going to start things off of the basket. We're up 2-0 right off the bat. Eagles come out in their traditional 3-quarter zone, causing some turnovers right off the bat, as Holy Family's going to turn things over right off the bat for the ball game. Eagles ball out of bounds. Eagles are up 4-0, 5:22 left here in the first quarter of play. Get the basket, get into the press, and take it from there, and that's what the Eagles want to do. There's a turnover, and Lane Lipkin is going to put it up. Eagles are up 6-0 right off the bat, scoring points off turnovers. Idea on the inbounds play, just didn't get the pass back to Myers as easily as they wanted. Turnover on the Eagles, and Holy Family will pick up the ball here, trying to get something going after a really, really rough first 2 minutes of the ball game. Loader by Myers off the mark, and now he's going to pick up a foul on the opposite side of the court. First foul on Myers, first team foul on the Eagles. McAllister's going to come in. Dane McAllister checks in. Another turnover by Oglesby as the Eagle defense really starting to pick things up here on that quarter court press. And the Eagles are reset in a half-court set, man-to-man by Oglesby. And a quick little dish and dive from Lipkeman to Lipkeman, and Wyatt Lipkeman gets his second basket of the game, and we are up 8-0, gang. 4 minutes to go left here in the first quarter.
Very good. Very good.
turnover as Oglesby is going to take a timeout. Timeout, Griggsville Perry, 3:54 left in the first quarter. Eagles up 8-0. Ball out of bounds, and they get right through the Oglesby press. Here comes Lane Lipkin down the lane, off the mark on the layup, and here comes Oglesby. Out of bounds, they official that back to the Holy Family team. 3:31 left in the first quarter. GP up 8-0. The scoring points off turnovers. The pressure getting to Oglesby a little bit here in the early going of the ball game. Wyatt Lipkin gets him wrapped up in a jump ball. Alternate possession is going to stay with Oglesby. They'll get the ball out underneath. GP in the 2-3 zone. And there is the first basket of the game for Oglesby, coming at the 3:11 mark. Eagles up 8-3. Another give and go. That's the second time that play has got the shot we wanted. Myers off the mark just a little bit. McAllister fights and scraps for the rebound and gets it out to Wyatt Lipkin. And here we go down to Lane. Lane down on the baseline. Gets blocked, and that's going to be out of bounds and will stay with the Eagles. Here comes Wade Lipkin, number 31, into the ballgame. He's going to sit down Flint Kurt. Ooh, telegraph pass from Lipkin to Lipkin, and Oglesby didn't have any trouble getting an eye on that and a hand on it. Turnover, Griggsville. Another shot off the mark. McAllister with the rebound, and here we go. Eagles really looking to push things up once again in transition, and we'll get set back up in a half court. Oglesby staying in man-to-man. Taking their time, trying to find a nice shot here. Wade Lipkin's going to take one from about 15 foot and just off the mark, and Oglesby will grab the rebound, and here we go back on defense. 1:14 left in the first quarter. Eagles up 8-3. GP has not scored in just about 3 minutes now here in the first quarter. Picked up some quick baskets in the first minute and a half, but have not put anything in the hoop in about 3 minutes. Dane McAllister whistled for the foul. That's going to be his first, team second. Flint Kurt's going to come back in for Wade Lipkin. Ogilvy's ball out of bounds on the sideline. 57 seconds left in the first quarter. tried to get it to the big guy inside. Eagles are going to take back over with 42 seconds left. It will be Griggsville Perry ball to begin the second quarter. We'll see if Coach White wants to go a little two for one here to finish out the quarter and start the second. Lane left him in at the top of the key, number 32. No count by the officials. Eagles start to get into an offensive movement and get set up in the 1-4. Here we go, 14 seconds on the clock. Myers drives down the lane, a little floater from 10 foot, no good. Oglesby comes down. Here they go. Time running out, and they're going to pick up a foul. Lane Lipkeman picks up the foul, his first, team third, 6 seconds on the clock here in the first quarter. Oglesby ball out of bounds, just about half court. They turn it over. Eagles have time for one more shot. 3 seconds. Here comes the Lane Lipkeman at the end of the buzzer. And it's good. End of the first quarter, guys. We are here at East Peoria Central Junior High. Griggsville Perry leads Oglesby Holy Family 10-3. Getting ready to start the second quarter. Eagles ball up 10-3. Let's see if we can get a basket right off the here to start the second quarter. Myers, McAllister, Wade, and Lane Lipkeman. Flint Kirk, the starting five for GP to begin the second frame. Gets it inside to Myers once again. Another layup, and it comes just short off the iron. Another turnover on Holy Family. Here come the Eagles in transition. Lane Lipkeman finds Wade Lipkeman. Wyatt Lipkeman gets another basket in, number 24. And the Eagles are up 12-3, 5:23 left here in the first. Another turnover. The Eagles are really starting to get things going with this transition pressure. And it's going to be a jump ball transition. Possession goes to Oglesby. They'll get the ball out of bounds. 5:16 left in the second. 12-3 lead for the Eagles. Oglesby tries getting it inside of the big guy. He has not had a lot of touches offensively. That's going to be a foul on number 3, Michael Myers. They've whistled that on Lane Lipkeman on the board. His first, team fourth. Now they get it up for Michael. That's going to be 2 on Myers. His fourth, his second, team fourth, 5:12 left here in the second quarter. GP back in the 2-3 zone as Oglesby looks to inbounds, and they get a quick shot right off of that, and that's going to be the first bucket for the big guy, number 21. That's who we told you to keep an eye on. It is 12-5. Griggsville Perry, 5 minutes left here in the first half. Wyatt Lipkin at the top of the key gets it over to Rory Phillips, who checked in here during the quarter break. Lane Lipkin at the top of the court now. Eagles set up in the 1-4. A risky little pass that almost got picked off. Wyatt Lipkin drives down to the middle of the lane. He finds McAllister. McAllister back in the corner. He goes back up to Wyatt Lipkin on the right wing. Wyatt penetrates. He passes off to Wade. To Lane. Lane passes off to Phillips. To McAllister. Eagles taking their time. Nice ball movement by Griggsville Perry as they try to look for an open shot here. Griggsville's burning a lot of time on this possession, pushing just about 1 minute worth of possession here. And that's going to be a shot from Flint Kirk on the left wing that falls short. Big fight for the rebound, and Oglesby comes up with it. Might have slipped that foot out of bounds, but here we go. And that's going to be a double dribble violation. They're saying he stepped out of bounds as well, and it's going to be Eagles basketball. Another turnover against Holy Family. Wade Lipkeman comes back in. He checks in for Flint Kirk. Eagles ball on the far side of the court. 3:43 left in the first half. Eagles up 12-5. They led 8-0 to start the ball game, scoring 4 points off of some possessions early in the first 90 seconds. Rory Phillips whips it around. McAllister gets it over to Wyatt Lipkeman in the corner for three, and it's good. Wyatt Lipkeman knocks one down, and the Eagles are up by 10, 15-5, 3:23 left in the second quarter. Get the ball in the basket, set up the press, and see where it goes from there, and they're going to say another step out of bounds on Oglesby. Another turnover for Holy Family. Eagles ball, 3:16 left in the second quarter. Garrett White says spread it out a little bit as Oglesby remains in the man-to-man defense they've been in. A little quick give-and-go from McAllister to Lipkeman and gets turned over underneath the basket. Here comes Oglesby. Looks for the big guy up ahead, and it's going to be a foul. A good foul by Rory Phillips, number two. If you're going to foul them, make sure they don't put it in the basket. So the big kid for Oglesby is going to go to the line. And Rory Phillips is going to pick up his first foul, team number five. First basket is good. It's 15-6, 2:59. Left here in the first half. Misses the second. Fight for the rebound comes up. And it's going to be Rory Phillips coming up with it. Fight on the floor. Scrappy play by Wyatt Lipkin to get it out. Gets it to Rory Phillips, and Garrett White's going to call a 30-second timeout. 2:56 left in the second quarter, guys. Eagles up 15-6. We're taking 30. Reset. Eagles ball out of bounds under the far side of the basket. Oglesby's going to come out in some full court pressure. 2:51 left here in the first half. Eagles up 15-6. On the court right now for the Eagles, all three Lipkemans, Rory Phillips and Dane McAllister, are the five on the floor, and that's going to be a turnover on the Eagles. Dane looked for Wyatt coming in on the underneath cut. Got a ball turnover. Here comes Oglesby. And that's going to be a double dribble. Another turnover on Oglesby. You know, a lot of us were talking around here at East Peoria as we've had several hours to rest and wait for this 5 o'clock semifinal, and one of the things we obviously talked about was don't turn the ball over. Doesn't matter if you're scoring a bunch of points. If you don't turn the ball over, you're going to be able to limit their opportunities to get the basket. And that's a nice little save on the official. A little break for the Eagles as we'll get the ball back and reset the offense. 1:56 left to go here in the first half. Lane Lipkeman at the top of the key. McAllister and Wade Lipkeman set up on the high post. Rory and Wyatt down underneath on the blocks as we get set up and the offense gets going. Rory Phillips whips it alongside to Wyatt Lipkeman in the left wing. He goes back to McAllister and over to Lane on the right wing. Lane Lipkeman on the right wing drives in a nice little floater, and it's going to go off the front of the rim, and Oglesby gets the rebound, and they're off and running. Holy Family pushes down to the right wing. Number 11, one of the two big guns we've said to keep an eye on. The Eagles have really done a nice job limiting the touches for number 11 and number 21 as the entry pass gets another turnover. Lipkeman to Lipkeman. Here comes Lane trying to find an open space. Doesn't find one. Kicks back out to McAllister, and it goes in and out of the rim. 1:05 left here in the second quarter. Holy Family ball, three-pointer in the corner. No good. Rory Phillips going to fight it up. And he's going to draw the foul from number 32. That is the first foul of the half against Oglesby. And that comes at 57 seconds left here in the second quarter. Michael Myers comes back in from DP. He sits down for Rory Phillips. He's had a heck of a role-playing job right here. Coming in the second quarter, Michael Myers comes in. He's got two fouls. 57 seconds left in the second quarter. Eagles bringing the ball down the court. Eagles hold possession, so if they can hold it through the rest of the quarter, score, they'll get the ball back to start the third. Lane Lipkeman at the top of the key. He pops up. Wyatt pops up and grabs the ball. Now back at the volleyball line. Eagles playing a little keep away, trying to bring some pressure. Michael Myers grabs it at the volleyball line now. Here we go, driving down the right side. 30 seconds left in the second quarter. Eagles burning some talk, looking for that last second shot here to end the first half. 20 seconds. Garrett's called things out. 15 seconds now left in the second quarter, and that's going to be a foul. Oglesby, not a bad foul. Second foul of the half. Stops the Eagles from getting the offense going here with 11 seconds left, and now we'll have to get it out of bounds and see if we can get this play set back up again. 11 seconds left. Myers is going to inbounds the ball. He gets it up to Lane Lipkeman past the volleyball line at half court. Wyatt Lipkeman, 4 seconds, finds Myers with a floater with 3 seconds, and it's good. Another basket of the buzzer for the Eagles, and they are excited, as are our Eagle fans. GP fans, we're up over Oglesby. Holy Family 17-6 at halftime. 180 of you watching. I hope 180 more join. We go to the break up 11, 17-6 here in the Class 7-1A state semifinal. We are at East Peoria Central Junior High School, located just off the East Washington exit as you come into the city of Peoria off of 74. Seeing some of the boys from Lincoln Carroll Catholic making their way down the steps. They'll be in the second semifinal against Washington St. Patrick. And that'll be the semifinal following us, scheduled for about 6:30. Nobody really in foul trouble for the Eagles. Michael Myers has two fouls. Everyone else just with one. Just two fouls called on Oglesby Holy Family in the first half, and those came just here in the here towards the end. So once again, if you're just joining us, there's a pair of Myers brothers walking down. They've played in these state tournament games before. Griggsville Perry will be back here on Thursday night, one way or the other. Regardless of this outcome, if the Eagles win, we'll play at 7:30 in the state championship game. If we lose, we will play at 6 o'clock. And once again, the other teams in the other semifinal, Washington St. Patrick and Lincoln Carroll Catholic, are on the other end. And it seemed like he was always away from the ball when we had the ball. We need that guy back around when we got the ball. Once again, a real nice crowd here tonight. Hope you guys will come up and join us on Thursday. One way or the other, whether it is the 6 or 7:30 game. Hopefully it'll be the 7:30 game, and we're just one half away from that. It has been a long, long, lengthy day up here at East Peoria. Once again, Griggsville won the opening game by about 6 points this morning over Newton St. Thomas. Both teams looked really, really shaky in the first quarter and a half. Eagles got things going defensively in the second half and finally were able to put things away. We watched Oglesby Holy Family, the team that you're watching right now, shoot the lights out of the gym as they beat Pontiac St. Mary's. If you remember, Pontiac St. Mary's was the team that Griggsville Perry lost to in the state championship game back in 2016 over at Bartonville Limestone Middle School. And a team that many people had looked at to be maybe one of the best teams in the tournament. Oglesby was down by as many as 12 in the second half, made a late, late rally, and were able to close things out and win by about 5 or 6. Washington St. Patrick had little trouble with Kewaunee Visitation in the third quarterfinal. It was a 15-5 halftime score and was never even honestly that close. So that's where we're at, 17-6. Our halftime scores. We've got 8 minutes left here on the halftime clock. Hello to Barry Wright, the Hall of Famer, joining us on Facebook. Nice to see Jamie Teal and all the kids from Waverly joining in tonight. Congratulations on the guys from Waverly on a fantastic sectional game played against us on Thursday night and a heck of a season. Definitely a tough team in the area. And the Eagles were fortunate to get past Thursday night and be here where we're at right now. So glad to have you guys hanging along. Well, we appreciate you watching Sharon TV. We're glad you're chiming in. We didn't recap the fourth quarterfinal for you. Lincoln Carroll Catholic had little trouble with Royal Prairie View Ogden. Royal Prairie View, the only other public school in this field of eight today. Lincoln Carroll Catholic jumped out to an 18-0 lead in the first quarter. And Royal really, really had trouble getting some shots off. Lincoln Carroll came out in a 3-2 zone right off the bat, and Royal was really never able to get any ball movement and really struggled to produce any offense in the first half. And what was really kind of a runaway win for Lincoln Carroll Catholic. They will face Washington St. Patrick. A good team, has a couple of nice guards on their roster for the Irish. But glad you guys are all chipping in. Glad I stayed and streamed it along too. Thanks to Jill Koonsman, who is taking care of scorebook duties for us at the Tornado game. As the boys are fighting pretty hard against Camp Point Central, and we're down 7.5. But it's a really, really nice setup we've got here at East Peoria Central. A really nice eating complex, eating concourse out before you make your way into the gymnasium. We've got a nice little two-level setup here. If you guys have ever been to Beardstown High School, it's a lot like Beardstown as we've got things set up here. And a nice little concourse area that the GP fans were eager to take over on this side. We told some people from the IESA that if we happen to be here on Thursday night, specifically in the 7:30 game, that you should make sure that GP is on the side with two levels of bleachers. We've pretty much got the lower level filled up now as it is, and a few late stragglers that have made their way up here into the upper concourse with us. So it's nice to have everyone joining alongside with us here tonight. I'm glad you guys are chiming along in, 130 of us here. Watching online, and how many ever extra are sitting along with them as the Eagles make their way back onto the court. 4:40 left here in the halftime break. Once again, the Eagles have done a great job limiting touches for the two big guns, number 21 and number 11 for Oglesby Holy Family. And make no doubt, folks, this team came out and shot the lights out against Pontiac St. Mary's in the first half. Halftime score for Pontiac St. Mary's and Oglesby Holy Family was somewhere in the realm of about 32-25. I mean, these two teams came out and lit the gym up this morning. So we are hopeful that the Eagles will keep this up. The defensive pressure has really started to make a lot of turnovers, probably close to 10 turnovers for Holy Family in the first half. Making making 3:50 left here, left in the second quarter. If you're just tuning in, thanks for joining us here. We are live from East Peoria Central Junior High in East Peoria, Illinois. It's been a long day as the Eagles had a very early bus ride. Stopped to get a little breakfast along the way. Won the 10 a.m. game, and we have been hanging out all afternoon. The boys and all the cheerleaders grabbed something to eat after the second quarterfinal game, made their way back here sometime during the fourth quarterfinal. Some of us stuck around, watched the rest of the tournament play out. It's been a nice day here. Pretty comfortable digs here at East Peoria Central. Eagles down, or excuse me, the Tornadoes down by 13, 57-44, just about 3:50 left over at Camp Point today as the high school boys had a game scheduled over at Camp Point. The junior high girls, 7th and 8th graders, had middle school volleyball for the Pike County Conference tournaments down in Pleasant Hill today. So we've been scattered everywhere, so we thought it would be a nice idea to bring you guys a live stream that you can check out. No matter where you're at. Saw a few of the junior high volleyball girls have made their ways up. For sure the high school boys will start tuning in as soon as their game concludes over at Camp Point. But once again, we'll be back here Thursday night, gang. One way or the other, we're going to be here on Thursday. If the Eagles pull off the win, we'll be here at 7:30 in the state championship, looking for our fourth state championship in school history. One way or the other, we're bringing home the 10th state trophy in Eagles program history. As we're down to just about 2 minutes left in the first half, Eagles now with an overall state tournament record of 37-26 in 29 state tournament appearances. This is the 17th tournament that we have now won at least one game.
The loser of the semifinal game will play the third place Thursday night at 6 o'clock p.m. The winner of tonight's semifinal game will play the state championship Thursday night at 7:30 p.m.
Richard Stickman standing over by us. He didn't want to do extra commentary, so he's just going to stand and watch the game. But that's all right. Craig Dunham checking in from the great state of Montana. Once again, it was nice to have Craig and all the guys back for the big 1989 reunion during homecoming. That was so much fun, and Craig and Jill Koonsman put in a lot of work to help make that happen. We're going to start the third quarter. Looks like starters for both sides, except McAllister will come in for Gerke to start the third quarter for GP. Eagles ball to begin the third quarter, up 17-6, and the inbounds comes to Lane Lipman. He goes over to Wyatt. In McAllister, far on the right, left wing, and down to Flint Kirk in the corner. 61-49 final in the Tornadoes game as Camp Point Central grabs the win over GP. Michael Myers from the corner for three, no good, off the rim, about the backboard, and here comes Holy. Holy family. Let's see what adjustments they try to make. As the Eagles stay back in the 2-3, they've now moved the big guy, number 21, back to the top of the key on the offense. He was trying to hang around in the lane as that hard pass goes off the hands of number 35 and out of bounds. Turnover, Ogilvy. Basketball goes to the Eagles as Myers will inbound to Lane Lipman on the far side of the court. 5:23 left in this third quarter. Eagles up 17-6. Wyatt left him on the left wing. He goes down to McAllister in the corner. McAllister fires up a three. It's no good off the back iron. And that's going to be out of bounds as Oglesby. We'll tell you what, folks. We are just not seeing the same Oglesby team as we did this morning for one reason or another. Credit it to the Eagles' defensive pressure. Maybe it's just the long stay here in East Peoria. Just a lot different team than we're seeing right now. Oglesby comes out in a 1-3-1 zone. That's the first time we've seen a zone come out from Oglesby today as the Eagles will try and reset and get accustomed to this. Michael Myers goes down from the left side off the back iron and rebound McAllister. Myers on the left wing drives in. He goes over to the lane, left him in, and McAllister. McAllister on the far side. Three balls, good. 20-6. Eagles are up by 14, 4:33 left here in the third quarter. Full court pressure by Griggsville Perry. Coast to coast for number 34. He goes off the iron. No good. Loose ball gets picked up by Lane Lipman. He finds Wyatt. Wyatt goes strong to the hole. Off the glass and in. 22-6. 4:12 left in the third quarter. Another tip by Lane Lipkin. He steps out of bounds. Almost another turnover for Holy Family as Lipkin got a hand on it. The hustle play fell out of bounds. 4:09 left in the third quarter. Eagles up 22-6. Full court pressure coming by GP. Levin with a shot off the front of the iron. No good. He grabs the loose ball rebound, and it's going to be a foul on the Eagles. Foul's going to be on number 5. That is Flint Kerr. That's going to be the first foul of the half for Griggsville Perry, his first of the game. They get the ball into the big guy inside, number 21, and that's where he needs to be. That's where he excels, and that's going to be just a little mental mistake as Wyatt Lipman thought the inbounds pass was going to go to someone else, and it's going to be a turnover for Oglesby. 3:51 left in the third, 22-8. Eagles with a sizable lead, but a lot of ball game to go. Inbounds to 35, and now it's another steal by Lane Lipman. Here comes Lane on the left side. Coast to coast, goes for the layup, and it's good. Another traveling violation. The full court pressure has Oglesby shook, and they're going to take a timeout. Full court timeout. Full timeout taken by Oglesby. Eagles up 24-8, 3:39 left here in the third quarter. Left here in the third period, 24-8. Eagles ball out of bounds off the turnover underneath their own basket. Michael Myers is going to inbounds box set for the Eagles as McAllister pops out. They go around to the Lipkins, and they're going to find Myers in the corner for the three ball. That's good. 27-8. The lead now for Griggsville Perry, 3:26 left in the third quarter. And they're going to call the foul on McAllister on the bump over there on the sideline. Foul on Dane McAllister is going to be his second personal. Second of the half against GP. This will be Oglesby ball out of bounds on the left sideline. They pop it in at number 11. They get it to the big guy inside. He whips it over to 32. A nice play by Oglesby. But the ball... ball falls just a little bit short off the iron. Here come the Eagles one more time. We're looking to add more to a 19-point lead with 3 minutes left here in the ballgame. Myers one more time. Off the back iron, fight for it. Lane Lipman tries to get it on a last-minute save, and he'll step out of bounds. Oglesby ball with 2:56 left in the third quarter. Guy with a shot. It's going to fall short. He tries to get the ball on the tip, and Myers is going to come up with it here on the far corner. He pushes up to Wyatt Lipman on the right side. He's at the wing, gives it back to Myers. Myers to Lane, Lipkin at the top of the key, and the Eagles will set up with 2:36 left in the third. Wyatt over to Myers. Myers to Lane in the corner. Myers cuts through. Makes it over to the left side. McAllister finds Myers where he came, but spot up, open shot. Three ball, good. Michael Myers knocks down another three, and the Eagles are up by 22. 30-8, 2:17 left in the third quarter. Another loose ball throw. And it's going to be Eagles ball and the loose ball foul by Oglesby, number 32. His first personal, I believe. First personal of the half against Oglesby, who's only been whistled now for three fouls in the matchup. 2:03 left in the third quarter, 30-8, Eagles lead. Myers on the left wing. He finds Lane Lipman at the top of the key. He gets a pick from McAllister, moves to the right side, finds brother Wyatt. Wyatt looks for Myers, streaking across the lane. They don't get it back, and here comes McAllister. McAllister, three ball is good, and the Eagles are up 33-8 with 1:43 left here in the third quarter. And there's another travel, as Oglesby has no answer for the full court pressure from Griggsville Perry. The Oglesby coach just walked down beside us. You can't see him in the view of the camera. Just looked down at one of his assistants and shook his head. As we get a foul that stops play, that's going to be number 24 for the Eagles. That is Wyatt Lipman. That's his first personal, third of the half against the Griggsville Perry. 1:31 left in the third, 33-8. Eagles up by a bunch. And the full court pressure trying to get more. And that's going to be an offensive foul. Turnover on Oglesby. Eagles ball down under their own basket one more time. Second foul of the half against Oglesby Holy Family, and they're going to take a timeout. 1:27 left in the third, guys. Eagles are up 33-8. Eagles ball out of bounds. Myers finds Wyatt Lipkin. He goes right back to Myers, who's going to put it up again. Off the back iron, rebound Wyatt Lipkin. He gets it back out to Lane, back at the volleyball line. Eagles will reset. 1:17 left in the third, and they are up 33-8 in the third quarter of the Class 7-1A state semifinal. McAllister at the top of the key finds Wyatt Lipkin on the right side. Overload for the Eagles now as they're going to burn some time. Oglesby drops back with just 1 minute left. You're going to have to get some pressure at some time, guys. A man-to-man 1-2-2 type of zone being thrown here by Oglesby. As we're down to 40 seconds, Oglesby will get the ball to begin the fourth quarter. As the Eagles continue to burn clock up 33-8. Lane Lipkin back at the half-court line. He gets it back to Wyatt on the left side. Flint Kirk dashing around at the bottom of the lane. McAllister on the right side. Myers hanging out over in the left wing. Seconds left on the clock as now Holy Family comes out trying to get a little pressure in the backcourt. Wyatt finds Lane on the right side. Wyatt goes all the way down to the corner. Same play they ran for Myers, and Wyatt puts it up. And he knocks it down. 36-8. Oh, my. You're into the third quarter, guys. Griggsville Perry, 36. Oglesby Holy Family, 8. As we have seen what is now a complete of a game from the Griggsville Perry Eagles, as we have seen in quite a while. And we will remind you, if we gain a 30-point advantage here in the fourth quarter, that clock will continue to run without being stopped, with the exception of a player foul out, a timeout, or an injury on the court. Once again, we'll remind you, state championship game, should the Eagles hold on here in the fourth quarter, will be at 7:30 Thursday night, right back here at East Peoria Central. As the Eagles are firing on all cylinders for the first time in what many, if you've watched any of the games, would probably say has been a good 2 or 3 weeks. And that's going to be another turnover on Holy Family, as they have just not had a lot of luck against the Eagles defense today. And like we told you guys earlier in this live stream, this is an entirely different team that we saw from 11:30 this morning against Pontiac St. Mary's. Myers gets one on the shot, goes off the back of the iron, and Holy Family gets the rebound. And here we go one more time, 5:30 left in the ballgame. And there's another trap. Many of the big guns for Holy Family are now on the bench with 5:27 left here in the ballgame. Eagles looking to get the 30-point advantage, and we'll get the running clock. Wyatt Lipman passes out to McAllister. He gets it down to Kirk in the right corner. Back to Myers at the top of the key. He drives in, finds Lane. Lipman on the right, left side. Off the iron, no good. But Wyatt grabs the rebound. 5:06 left in the ballgame. Myers at the top of the key. To Lane Lipman on the left side. Eagles reset as Lipman gets to the volleyball line. He gets a pick from McAllister. Gets it over to Wyatt Lipman on the right side. Myers dashes through the lane. Not a look there. He goes back to the corner. And the Eagles continue the motion offense. Here comes Lane Lipman on the right side. He gets it to Wyatt in the corner. Here comes Myers. Myers meets the friendly roll, and that's going to be it. 30-point lead, folks, and we're going to run the clock for the last 4:36. So let's set things up as we are talking for Thursday night. The Eagles will play in the 7-1A state championship game. That is coming up Thursday night at 7:30 as Lane Lipman gets another pass and a layup, and now Coach White's going to empty the bench. We see Garrett Woodward, we see Gerke, we see Rory Phillips getting ready to check in, and here comes another layup off of a turnover, and the route is on. It's 40-8 with 4 minutes left in a running clock fourth quarter, and we have seen as complete of a game from the Eagles, my goodness, as we've seen quite a while. They got a heck of a fight against Waverly in the sectional. Struggled just a little bit to kick things off, and now Lane Lipman's going to get another one, and White's going to call a 30-second timeout as we're going to get the subs in. Gerke, Rory Phillips, Garrett Woodward all coming in as we're going to clear the bench. 3:35 left here in the fourth quarter. Just a 30-second timeout, but we're taking a little bit longer. 3:42 left in the ballgame. Eagles are up 44-8 in the state semifinal against Oglesby Holy Family. Eagles will play at 7:30 for the state championship game. We'll find somebody to come up here and broadcast the thing. If not, I guess I'll do it too. But they will play the winner of Lincoln Carroll Catholic and Washington St. Patrick coming up here in just a little bit. We will be right back here at East Peoria Central Junior High on Thursday, gang, as we find Rory Phillips. And I'll tell you what, if anyone in that group deserved a basket today, it's Rory Phillips after the way he came in and played some role plays there for Griggsville Perry. He deserved that basket as much as anybody did today, guys. Once again, we're in a running clock. So Oglesby will set up for free throws, but the clock is going to continue to run. 2:50 left here in the game as the Eagles are up 46-8. We expected, honestly, a pretty close game here today. We genuinely thought this was going to be a barn burner, folks. Oglesby rallied to beat Pontiac St. Mary's earlier this morning. Second free throw up, bounces around the rim, and it's a fight for the rebound. And Wade Lipkeman gets it out to Gerke, and here comes Woodward. 2:11 left in the running clock, fourth quarter. Eagles up by 38. Who would have thought that? But folks, we will encourage you, if you're nearby, if you're within driving distance Thursday night, get in the car, grab a friend, and grab three, and get yourself over to East Peoria Central Junior High. It's not too hard to get to. It's just off of 74. But the Eagles will be playing for their fourth state championship game in school history. Just 3 years removed from the last time in 2016 when we fell short to Pontiac St. Mary's.
Good job, Ray! That's one, guys!
Defense!
Once again, the Eagles, the 8th grade regional, still going to finish up on Monday. We'll face Lovejoy over at Perry, and that's a 6:30 tip-off. So you can come watch the boys as we're down to a minute left in the running clock. Monday night, we're going to take Lovejoy on in the 8th grade regional final. That's going to be at Perry, starting at 6:30. If the Eagles are able to upset Lovejoy, they will play in the sectional. That'll be Wednesday night, back at Perry in the 8th grade sectional. So it's going to be a long, busy week of basketball. Tornadoes are on the road Tuesday night at ISD. We'll be at home Monday night against South County. As we're down to 25 seconds, guys, and we're going to wrap things up here, the Eagles are going to punch a ticket for the Class 1A 7th grade state championship game. With the most impressive of wins, 46-8 is going to be the final score as we're down to less than 10 seconds, and the Eagle fans are on their feet. And there we go. Shot at the buzzer falls short, and Griggsville Perry is on their way to the state championship game, 46-8. And one heck of a performance from the Griggsville Perry Eagles. Defense got the offense going, and the offense responded after that as the Eagles are going to head back to the locker room. One happy group of boys. Oh my. Another state championship game appearance for Garrett White and his short tenure here at Griggsville Perry, and what a job he's done with these kids. Wow, wow, wee wow. That was quite a deal, folks. From top to bottom, the Eagles brought their A game tonight. So once again, let's wrap things up for you, and we might try and actually stream some of the next game too. I don't know who's going to stick around here and watch, but we might reset and stream the next semifinal if you guys want to watch any of Lincoln Carroll Catholic and Washington St. Patrick. We might get that fired up here in just a little bit as we'll have a little bit of a break, and I probably need to reset the battery on this phone. But Eagles will play 7:30, guys, on Thursday night for a state championship game. We'll find one way or the other to stream this bad boy. But once again, we'd rather have you guys here hanging out with us as the Eagles win 46-8. And we'll play in the state championship. Guys, thanks for hanging out with us all day long. It's not a pro-level broadcast, but that's okay. That's what we do here. We just get through the day. So we'll see you guys later. If you want, we're going to fire up this next game stream and probably won't have any commentary with it. We'll just let it go if you guys want to watch it. So we'll see you all later. Go Eagles.